Thank you, Holy Spirit, Lord. We give you glory. We magnify your glorious name. We adore you, O Lord. Blessed be unto thy holy name, for thou art the King of kings. Blessed be unto thy holy name, for thou art eternal King of glory. We worship you, our Lord, our God, and our Savior. We enthrone you and we adore you, for thou art King of kings and Lord of lords. Take glory, wonderful, and the miracle-working God. Take glory, perfect God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Take glory, eternal King of glory, who is unto like thee, and who is to compare with thee. Be thou exalted, O Lord. Thank you, Holy Spirit, Lord. Thank you, living, mighty Father God. Thank you, wonderful, and the miracle-working God. Thank you, King of kings. Messiah is the King of kings. Oh, Messiah is the Lord of lords. Yeah, Messiah is the King of kings. Messiah is the Lord of lords. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, 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 yeah, 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 hallelujah. I see Messiah is the King of kings, yeah, yeah, yeah. Messiah is the Lord of lords, yeah, Messiah Is the King of King, Masha Baba Yakaburu Shenduri Amea Sama Mama, Rakabo Sakabea Sakataburu Shanduri Ama. Yeah, Messiah is the Lord of Lords. Hallelujah. Yemaya Sanduri Ama, Yeshaba Yasakaburu Shekiri Asanduri Ama. Alleluia. 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 Today I'm going to share the word of God with you, which I have been entitled Stand on the Rock. Stand on the Rock or Hide in the Rock. Keep yourself in the rock. Rock is when that consider as an stronghold. Rock is where as consider as a neutral ground, as an especial places. Whenever you want to speak with God, God told Moses, Moses, go on my mountain, on top of my mountain, and I will speak to you. Muslim, in time like this, you need to go to the mountain. You need to stand on the rock. You need to be at an especial place. Many people consider a moment like this as the best place in their life, but this is not the time for enjoyment. This is in every ceremonial moment, one have to consider that ceremonial mostly consist with the blood, or mostly go with the bloodshed, mostly go with a serious issue or an incident. In time of celebration or ceremonial movement like this, many souls encounter trouble, and here is where many souls have been cut down or used to be cut down. But I want to tell you that this is not the time to ignorant the spiritual movement, because in time like this, everybody is preparing for an spiritual movement, but most of Christians don't consider at this moment as their time. We consider this moment as a moment of enjoy, satisfy our feeling. But let me tell you one thing, this is not the time of ceremony. This is the time that one have to stand in fasting and in prayer. This is the time that one have to fight. This is the time that one have to, be at the right position. This is the time that you need to position yourself at the right place. This is the time that you have to hear the voice of God. Before you enter into 2018, you must know your ground and your stand and your movement and how you are going to walk with the Lord. You must hear the voice of God in time like this. But many people always are busy after the financial issues. But that is not the case. The case is, where are you now at this year? At this year, where are you now? Where are you toward to? I want to invite you into your spiritual, place, that this is the time that one have to, be in a good place. This is the time that one have to acknowledge the spiritual grounds that my brother, my sister, wherever you are, whatever happens, this is the time that one have to stand and pray and talk with God. This is the time of spiritual movement. In time like this, many people go around the spiritual world, and here is where we fall in victim, as if God is not with our side. Many men of God are going to hiding place, hiding themselves and pray and connect themselves to God to get the right information for the year coming. But many people also consider this is the movement. Yeah, it's good you prepare yourself for the ceremonial movement as Christmas in your church, whatever you are doing. But this should not, hinder your spiritual grounds. This should not hinder your spiritual movement. This should not stop your spiritual activities. This is the time that one have to go into his inner. In time like this, not only pastors are needed to appear before God. Whomsoever that believe himself must appear before God as a true Christian. If you really know that you have given yourself, totally give yourself to God, you have really dedicated yourself to God as a spiritual servant or as a saint of the living God, this is the time that you need to appear before God so that you can know what is going to happen ahead of you, so that you can obtain the grace, you can obtain the mercy. You need to prepare yourself to enter into 2018 in a special moment. But many people don't care for this. All what we care about is, how can I make it? Many people are so busy that they cannot have time for themselves. Even prayer has become a trouble or a problem for many of us. But I want to tell you, my brother, my sister, wherever you are, don't allow the movement at this moment is the time that whomsoever you are, you must prepare yourself. Whether you are king, whether you are queen, whether you are pastor, whatever, whomsoever you are, I'm encouraging brethren, we don't have to ignore the moment of ceremonial time like this. We need to arise. We need to awake. We need to move. We need to stand firm in his glory so that we will see his divine manifestation. We don't have to allow enemy to take us into captivity before we're beginning to report an issue which is very ill. This is the time that I'm encouraging all the brethren that whatever you are, my brother, my sister, stand firm. You need to stand on your position. You need to claim your position. This is the time that one has to appear before God. Prepare yourself. Stand on the rock. You cannot stand anywhere. Means you can't just take things for granted. Spiritual things, you can't take it for granted. I want you to understand that this is the time that I'm praying with you. This is the time that we have to show concern in the spiritual movement so that we can win the victory ahead of us. And I know that by the grace of God, at the year 2018, you are going to be an exorcist somebody. You are going to exceed your dream. You are going to exceed above your dream. What you thought, what you think, you are going to exceed that. I want you to acknowledge the spiritual movement in your life, the spiritual ways in your life, so that you'll be able to obtain the grace and the mercy of God upon your life, so that your life will not live in a miserable life. This is the time that one has to make correction of your life. This is the time that one have to acknowledge his way of life, that I'm not just a common person, but you have to understand yourself that God has a thought, God has a plan for you. This is the time that you have to see divine manifestation of the Holy Spirit in your life. Brethren, this is the time that one must take his Bible and define himself in the Bible. Whether you are a man or a woman, whomsoever you are, I want to tell you that you need to know the actual goal of God for you for this moment that we are. And I pray that before end of this month, you must achieve a divine visitation. It's one of the most important things that every Christian must get. Every year, you need to have a divine encounter with God. You need to have divine encounter with the Holy Spirit. You need to have divine encounter with Jesus. Oh, in time like this, Jesus appeared to so many people. And in time like this, many of us also ignorant our way of life. We just take everything as the way we can do. But let me tell you, this is the moment that I need your attention in the scripture. This is the moment that I need your attention in the scripture. All those on board, may God bless you wherever you are. Wherever you are, whomsoever that is on board, may God bless all of you. And I pray that God Almighty will visit you from now into the end of this year. You must encounter with God. Not only pastors. At this moment, pastors are going to hiding out. Prophets are going to hiding out. Where are they? They are not doing programs. God, this is the time that they are consulting. We are consulting our God to give us things ahead of our Bible said, before anything, I reveal unto those who trust in me. I reveal unto my prophet. I reveal unto my children. And so being a child of God, God always need to have divine encounter with you to give you information ahead, to assist you, to give you a guideline, to give you a new project, to give you guideline, to give you an agenda of sources. Bible said, I have a thought of good, not thought of evil. And so how can you hear the thought of good? How can you understand your father agenda if you did not go to your father? In time like this, many people are going to visit. People are going to visit their parents, and many people are going home from abroad. And many people also from home coming to abroad, visiting people. But whom are you visiting? In times like this, many people are going to their places or their shrines to go and visit them and give their thanks offering. And where are you taking your thanks offering this moment? Whom do you depend on? I pray that you understand my voice today and go according to the scripture or divine principles of talking with God. And I know you are going to get a God agenda in your life. The reason why most of our time we fall in victims in our Christian race with our lifestyle is sometimes we don't get the accurate agenda of God in our life to achieve our goals. So we mostly look at friends and consider things. This is the time one has to act alone. If you try to act with somebody, it might not help you. This is the time that one has to separate from friend, from father, from mother, from wife, from children, from anybody. You need to keep yourself alone to wait upon the Lord for a divine encounter. Why? Bible says Hannah went alone when he needed to encounter with God. I'm acknowledging all brothers and sisters, Max Dante, God bless you. Frank G, God bless you. Saint Senefa, God bless you. Nicolas Sechi, God bless you. Becky Combat, oh, First Lady, God bless you. Juliet Kufa, God bless all of you. Juliet Samuel Edwisa, God bless you. Joseph Figura, bienvenido. I think you are Spanish also. Eric Amponsa, God bless you. Nana Badu, God bless all of you. Kofi Benson, please, you are all welcome in the name of the Lord, and I'm acknowledging you as a special saint of God or children of God. And I pray that at this moment, as we are sharing the word of God, I pray that may God visit you. Divine encounter is the most important thing that every Christian needed. This is the time that one have to understand the divine encounter with God. But how do you encounter with God? Bible said Moses went into the mountains, and here is where Jesus was waiting for him. God was waiting for him. Holy Spirit was there to demonstrate, to call his attention. And here is where he encountered with God, to have God agenda to lead him to his journey. So this is the time that you need to have God agenda upon your life. Asante Kafat, God bless all of you. God bless everybody that is on board. Whatever you are, please, I need your assistance. I need your help. Please share this program for me. And also, if possible, invite people on your mobile or on your phone or on your tab, however you are managing to get it. Please help me. I need your support of the program, not financial support, but physical assistance is what I always need from you. When you come, please help me. Send it to somebody or tag somebody or send it as message to somebody. And if possible, if you invite people, it go quickly for people to get connected to the program, because many people don't have my contact direct because they are not on my page and they also wish to be on it. So let me share with you on the title, Stand on the Rock. The rock, on top of rock or in the rock, have different sound. Whenever, whosoever you are, if you go at the rock place, the sounds are quite different. Kofi, God bless all of you. God bless all of you. Erica Ponsa, God bless all of you. Nana Badu, please, all of you, help me to share. Now, when you go to the mountains, you hear different sounds. The wind over there are different. Everything you see there are different. And you see very far. So if you don't have a good sight, when you go to mountain, no matter how you see a far bit, but if you have a good sight, you see very far. This is the time that you need to meet God for God's agenda in your life, so that you can move according to the will of God. Not every time that you need a prophet to tell you that, look, here you are going to enter, this is going to happen, this is that and that, you have to be doing this, that and that and that. Sometimes my option or my decision or my point of view is every Christian must have divine encounter with God, not only prophet, not only pastor, or not only apostle or archbishop. I'm not against that, even though I'm a prophet, but it's not obligation or it's not advisable to make myself God. I tell you the truth. Someone might ask, oh, man of God, I see this. Then I can help you to interpret it or to pray with you or to give you idea or to speak with you. But if you yourself got some revelation concern yourself, it give you the interpretation clear. And it helps you to do what you ought to do because you yourself have got the connection with God. Suppose Joseph go to Pharaoh and say, man of a king, you know something that has happened. Suppose somebody dream and told King Pharaoh that this is going to happen. You have been ignorant it. He might ignorant it. But it was because he himself, the king himself, dreamed. An interpretation came out according to the dream. And then he was able to keep himself in order. And he was able to put the right person in the position. For you to put yourself at the right position, one thing you ought to do is to get something by yourself. I pray that before end of this year, you must get a revelation of an agenda of God in your life. Omono, God bless you. You are welcome. God bless you wherever you are. Help me to start to invite people or share it to the people for me. So we need to, sometimes you need to be at neutral places. Yes, what Jesus said, when you want to fast, go in your inner door. What did he try to mean? Sometimes you need to keep yourself alone. This is the time that you have to sit down and analyze your life. Whom do you have to go with? How are you going to make your life? And what class of star? And what lay or what line are you going to join yourself with? This is the time that you need to subtract any negative relationship in your life. This is the time that you need to go away from presence of people where you don't belong to. Not everybody belongs to the public. You have to be very careful. There is a moment that you need to appear to public, and there is a moment that you need to hide yourself from public. Not every year you have to be so star. Sometimes you need to take your star and put it in your pocket and hide yourself. Not every time that you need to get fans. We don't go up. So that when you go up, you rest so that you get strength to move. This is the year that you need to subtract friends from your life. There are some friends that are not necessary to be part of you. If you really want to see divine manifestation of God, if you really want to encounter with God, there are some relationships you need to cancel them. Practically, there are some friends that you need to go away from them. Practically, there are some even family that you need to go away with them. Because not everybody that wish you good. Listen, at this 2018 that you are going, if you have any friend that doesn't come out to support your vision, that is a vision or dream killer, go away from dream killers. Somebody that don't respect your destiny, go away from that person. I'm not telling you to squeeze your face or beginning to fight with people. I'm telling you right thing to do. Till here, but I feel you. I feel you could remember. Nipebiya on najune nakuma M1 ya wuye biya chongu fini chay. Ne ubiya le ya damfu eso mani diwa chia fia fia se wongu awo nanti angonam nani nami enyang kutabudi. Ne damfu biya ne se diwa chia afia you could remember. Nipebiya uku ni swedi huu. No one found Yashi, who be beyond Yashi, my be a chum, freedom check. Now, send what my you. Yes, what turn the crew man, why I said what, and if the crew more from Panama. Suppose Jesus remained at his time, he has remained as whom he is, because they did not take him for anything, and they take him for granted. So, Jesus also, that is why Jesus did not grow up there. He go out to be, to grow up. This is the time that you need to subtract some of boyfriend, girlfriends, or practical friends, and that. There are people that they are dream killers. They listen to dream and kill dream. They don't give support to an idea. Whatever you mention, they always focus on your weaknesses, not on your best effort. There are friends that assist weaknesses or weak efforts to be strong. But at the end, they will defeat you at the last point. Go away from deception, friends. Sometimes God don't want you to work with people. He wants you alone. If you didn't listen to this advice, you become Moses. God will send you to far desert to become alone, to accept defeat, to walk alone. And from there, he will call you and send you back. I'm telling you the truth. Let's go on the one topic or one from a start from our quotation. My sister, Safwa, God bless you all. Amen. God bless you, whoever you are. Help me to share the program with better people, as my brother Ambassador Daniel Jr., also a senior, Johnny Senior. God bless you also, whoever you are. You help me to share the program, invited. And God bless all those in different countries, wherever you are. God bless all of you. Let's go into first. Let's start from the First Kings chapter 19, from 8 to 13. First Kings chapter 19, 8 to 13. First Kings chapter 19, 8. And he arose and did eat and drink and went in the strength of the meet 40 days and 40 nights to Horeb, the mountain of God. Now, the journey begins with Elijah. After all the issues, he must go to somewhere to meet God. Sometimes you have to discuss, ask yourself, how can you meet God properly? If you need to go to prayer camp, go there and join the prayer. If you need to keep yourself indoor, do that. If you need to visit one of your spiritual father or your spiritual brother or sister somewhere that you can hide yourself for maybe dry for 1 week, 7 days, 3 days, for to do extra exercise, you need to do it. This is the time. But this is the time that many people are making unnecessary journey. And here's where enemy trap us and many incidents happens. I'm going to visit my sister in ba 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 ba. He goes and something happened. I'm going to visit my friend, my classmate, my this and that. What is an agenda of the movement? And many people make wrong journey. Hey, I have one girlfriend, so I have one boyfriend, so I get connected to so. What are you going to do with the journey? What journey are you making? Don't make evil journey. Make a righteous journey at the end of the year like this, so that you can achieve the goals. Many people don't have an agenda at this moment, at this time like this. Many people don't have agenda. We are after the friend's agenda, the public agenda. What is your agenda at the end of the year like this? What agenda have you? How have you programmed yourself? How have you programmed yourself? John, God bless you, all of you. Help me to share the message and invite the people also. I need all of you. I need everybody to show concern at this time on the program, because through you, somebody has been blessed. Now, he must go to Mount Horeb, a mountain of God. This moment, this month, within this week or this day, before end of the month, you must make a journey to God. You must go in a principal way to meet God, to approach God. Let God see your concern. This is the time that you have to go and visit your parents, right? Or you have to visit your family or a best friend or whatsoever or whomsoever that necessary. This is the time that many people are going to their shrines to say, thank you, daddy, thank you, ba ba ba. But I'm not against you, but you need to also set a spiritual plan or agenda in your life that I'm going to fast for this. I'm going to hide myself for this. I'm going to pray for this. You need to make agenda and present your budget before God. So God, This is how you have brought me so far. Please help me before end of 2018. Please, this is my supplication. Before 2018, my God, may I have a child. May I have a husband. May I have a paper. May I get a healing from this. May this trouble go away from me. Take care of me from keep me from the hand of my enemy. Please help me for my journey that I want to make to so, please. Please help me for my documents. Please help me for this case. May I win this case. Please help me for this. Oh, you need to make a project, an agenda to God before you enter into 2018. And so you have to go to Mount Herod, the mountain of God. And he came hither unto the cave and lodged there. Where did he go? He went to the cave on the mountain Herod and do what? Lodged there, standing on the rock. You need to, right? This is the moment that you need to go into the cave of the mountain. This is the time that you need to go and hide yourself. You might have a prophecy which have not yet fulfilled. You must go and approach God on it. God, I'm still waiting on my promise. Abraham yearly I prayed to God and said, God, here I am. Oh, satisfy my soul. Let me one time love. May my enemy never love me to the end. For those who love last, love best. May I love last. Look at my age. Doctor say because of your age, you cannot give birth to child. Doctor say because of your age, you cannot do this. And they say because of this and that, you can't do that. But I want to tell you that this is the time that you need divine encounter with God. So he go to God. And so at that time that Elijah was in trouble and he wanted to speak with God, God wants to make him a super. And so he sent him and said, go there and then make a journey. And go ahead in the mountain of God. And Bible said in verse 9, that is the book of 1 Kings chapter 19, verse 9 going down. And he came hither unto the cave and lodged there. And behold, the word of the Lord came unto him. And he said unto him, why do thou hear Elijah? Without appearing to God, God will not have time to speak with you. Alicia Yeboa, God bless you. I'm Emmanuel Kwadjo Opong. God bless all of you. Help me to share this program and invite people. And bless somebody by this word. By invite somebody or tag somebody. How your system will help you to do that to support this program. And now, he said, what do you want here, Elijah? It's the same God that asked him to go there because that is the exactly place you need to make appointment with God. You need to take appointment with God. And so he went that day. He went there, keep himself at that place. And when Bible said, inside the cave. And you hear the word of God. What art thou here? What do you want? He went with a supplication. He went with agenda. But God have another agenda. And so here's where I'm encouraging brethren and sisters. We sometimes pray over pray. There is time for supplication. There is time for waiting. And there is time for presenting and issues. There are different category system of prayer. But we meet all together. But he went to God at that moment and said, Elijah, what do you want here? You mean God did not know what is going on? You mean God don't know his heart or his mind? God is omnipresent God. He's omnipotent God. He's omniscient God. He knows everything, but he must report himself as a prophet of God. He must prove the maturity as a prophet of God. You must prove maturity as a child of God. If you walk with God ignorantly, you always fail, and it seems somebody is dealing against your life. Yes, it could be, but yet, if you present your case at the rightful way, with the right principle, There you will find the favor. There God will speak to you. I pray that before end of this year, maybe you will never see God before you must see God. Maybe you will never see Jesus before you must see Jesus. Maybe you will never hear the Holy Spirit, you must hear the Holy Spirit. What do I mean you must see them? You need to have a divine encounter, what you will never you have ever had before. Maybe you have had it, but you need to have it in again a supernatural system way. May God bless all those who hear my voice, and I pray that whomsoever that is going under the shadow of my voice will get divine visitation or divine encounter with God. If the person will agree and subtract his life from people and go away from people, Elijah go alone when he wanted to speak with God. I'm not saying go away from your church. Maybe your church is doing program. You need to have an agenda of that program to present yourself in that program. Maybe you know, maybe you are not been going somewhere anyhow, but you need to pray. If you cannot pray in your house, that will be effective. You need to join where people are making. This time, if you invite somebody for prayer program or for revival, I have visitor and I'm going to visit somebody, and everybody is giving excuse not to go to prayer revival, but going to where people are joining themselves and doing what they want. I'm not against that, but ask yourself, who are you? And how do you live? Where do you belong to? Don't act yourself with people. As I've already advised you, 2018, go away from any friend that don't support vision and dream. Go away from dream killers. Go away. There are some friends. When they need help, you do. But when you need help, they quickly give excuse. They quickly reject it. They always boycott your agendas. Go away from there. What are you doing with that kind of person? But the big part and said, Nipe bia ufi usha abrabono onone dienkwa no pe uwo de de huni dienu chongu fri no. Sometimes God wants you to go away from some people. If you are working with a deceiver, God will not allow that person to deceive him. So always God will allow you to go to receive your deception movement. So sometimes you need to go away from any friend who is a treason somebody. When you talk of treason somebody, people who use their mouth to support you, but in terms of act, they refuse you, they reject you totally. They always don't care how you end up of your movement or your issue or your cases. They don't care. They find you as your food. They can encourage you. They can just give you hope, but they don't do right thing to give you hope. Keep aside from such kind of relationship. It doesn't help. Elijah went alone and keep himself. Why God did not go and talk with 300 people, 400 people, prophet that they have been hiding, or God have kept them? But the one who was walking alone, trying to mind his business with God, God spoke with him. God bless you, Collins. God bless you, wherever you are. And Nana, God bless you. God bless all of you. Please help me to share the message. This is standing on the rock. This is the time that one has to stand alone. Standing on the rock sometimes is fearful, sometimes is hard, because they're on top of rock, or being where the rock is also there are where demons are. There are where different wild animals are. There are different conditions over there. It's unfavorable condition. But here is where God wants you to prove maturity. Prove what? Spiritual maturity. And that will, God can understand you that you can do it. And so Bible says he went there. He went and lodged there. I repeat the verse. And he came hither into cave and lodged there. And behold, the word of the Lord came to him, and he said unto him, what do thou here, Elijah? And another person will say, what are you doing here, Elijah? Or what do you want, Elijah? Mm-hmm. And he said, I have been very generous for the Lord God of hosts, for the children of Israel have forsake their covenant, threw down the altar and sealed the prophet with the sword, and I only am left, and they seek my life to take it away. He go with God with his agenda, his problem. He was generous for God. Do you generous for God? By how? Many ministers are going on their knees and cry that God, look at how the ministry have become. Look at how best I'm doing. What should I do, God? Should I stop from this ministry? Should I go away from this ministry? Are you the one that called me? Look at how the ministry is going, but you don't care. All what you are doing is you are making your business and get money. You are always with the fat, with the church. And even at the end of the day, this church is going down. I don't know. The pastor has done something. Even this church, you begin to point out the mistakes. We have to stop pointing hand on people. Can you go on your knees and intercede on behalf of that ministry? Can we go on our knees and intercede on behalf of our ministry? The ministry is always going down. The ministry is always going down. People are going out with false stories. In this ministry, when you pregnant and you didn't take care, you miscarried. Why don't you go to God? Have you approached your pastor? Have you taken counseling? Have you approached your doctor? Are you doing best as you can? Have you gone on your knees that God, please, just give me one son or one daughter? And I will do this. Have you vowed with God? Somebody say, I vow. And you are crying on somebody. And that my sister-in-law, that my mother-in-law, that you have to stop that cry. Kill that cry. It is destroying the quality of your prayer. Put your hope in God. Forget about if somebody is responsible or not. We need to go on to God. He was jealous after God's ministry. That the church is scattered. Look at what is happening in that church. Look at what is going on in the church. God, what should we do? Help the pastor. Please, the church is going down. And so he was jealous of the work of God. You are a part of the ministry, but when the problem is coming in the ministry, you quickly, find exit, and you begin to accuse the somebody, punching hand on people. Many ministers, when things go on, instead of wait upon the Lord, we quickly close the ministry, go and start somewhere, because that is where you know people. And you'll be opening ministry upon ministry. Yet you are every day opening a new ministry, and none of them have been survived. You need to go on your knees at this moment. That God, are you one that make me a prophet? Am I a true prophet? Please speak. Should I continue to do the work? People are pointing hand on me, and people are blackmailing me. What should I? What do I have to do? We don't need to stand with anybody that will talk against me. You know that I'm a prophet of God. Is that a prayer or is that a fighting? God, look at what is going on. What do I have to do? Please, this is the time that if you are a true Christian, you need to go on your knees, call upon the name of the Lord. This is the time that you need to sit down and examine your life, and you subtract those who doesn't help your life. Take away dream killers out of your life. People who don't assist you better, take them away of your life. Go away from any evil relationship that doesn't please God. Because many people are destroyed because of friends. Bible said, if you make those who make many friends destroy themselves, there are friends that they always soak from you. But when you need help, they open teeth, evil teeth on you that, I can't. They straightforward tell you their position when you need help. They are always looking. They are good in teaching you or robbing you. There are treason friends that we need to go away from them. Treason people that we need to go away from them. This is the time to walk alone with God. Don't allow people to deceive you.
A friend have deceived you first time, second time, third time. You are saying, God don't work with fools. We have to be wise. He said we have to be wise as what? As serpent. So we have to know our position. We have to know who to work with. I pray and I advise that from now onwards, subtract yourself from the society, the environment, and begin to work alone with God. This is the time to hide yourself. 2018, hide yourself and let God bring you up. Because when you are working with dream killers, when you are working with a robbing friends, when you are working with, pretended friends, or if you are in pretended relationship, you always cry in vain. That man said he will marry me, and a man wants to marry you. I believe with you first year, second year, third year, fourth year. What that man want to do before he married you? Come on. At the end, he said, I have one at home, and that lady, make your position right with God. This year is the year. I tell you, from now to December, you must find an special moment to meet God, talk to God, pray to God, call upon the name of the Lord. If your place is not permitted, go and book hotel somewhere, go to prayer camp somewhere, join yourself with any revival that people are going, join yourself there, pray and see the, I say make agenda to God, let God know your agenda, make a budget to God that God, look at what I want to do, help me. Bible said, ask your heart desire and he will give to you. What agenda are you taking to God? You are just following people to go and dance, anyhow dance in the church there. God bless all of you, CK Junior. God bless you. Sister Higa, God bless all of you. Fifi, Gudra, God bless you. And Emmanuel Pipla, God bless all of you. And you are all welcome in the name of the Lord. Please help me to invite the people and share the message to people, because this is the time we all are treating standing on the rock. Minister to me and I minister to you. How do you minister to me? You minister to me by inviting the people also, because if you are extending the program, you are the one that is ministering. Invite somebody to get this revelation. For Bible says, lack of knowledge, people are perish. We don't go to God. We go to friends. We take our issues into a friend whom we don't know. A friend who always come out with wrong option. And any advice or opinion of that person lead you to downfall. You still consider as a best friend. But let me tell you, this is the time that you need to walk completely with God. Samuel, God bless all of you. Please help me to share this message and invite the people, wherever you are. I need your attention to assist. And now, we are in the book of 1 Kings chapter 19, from 8 coming down, we are now in time there. And he said, I have been very joyful for the Lord of hosts, for the children of Israel have forsaken their covenant, threw down the thin altar, selling the prophet with the sword, and I only left, and they seek my life to take it away. 11. And he said, go forth and stand upon the mountain before the Lord. And behold, the Lord passed by and a great wind. First option of God, he said, go and stand before the rock. Stand on the rock. Stand on the rock. Prepare yourself to hear the voice of God before end of this year. I repeat, prepare yourself to hear the voice of God before end of this year. Prepare yourself for divine revelation before end of this year. Present your agenda before God before end of this year. Present your budget before God before end of this year. Let God know your vision, your goal, your determination before end of this year. Present yourself. Stand on the rock. Go somewhere. Hide yourself. 3, 4, 7, as many as you can fast. You can cry that you know you are working with God. Do so. And God is living God. He's not God of talking. God needs people who seek him diligently. And so he said, go and stand on the mountain. I repeat 11. And he said, who said so? Who says so? It's God. He said, go forth and stand upon the mountain before the Lord. I'm encouraging brethren and sisters, wherever you are, you need to join yourself with God. You need to involve yourself with God's business. You need to present yourself before God, you yourself. And God will reveal himself to you. This is the time that one has to reveal himself, approach God. But without holiness, no one will see God. This is the time that you need to, make your yes, yes, and no, no to God. Make no, no to God, yes, yes to God. This is the time that you need to present yourself as a servant of God and approach God. And God will reveal himself to you. If you didn't take care, it seems God is not in your side, or it seems the pastor or the prophet is not, praying for you where, or no. All these things is not part of Christianity. The actual business in the Christianity is let God know you. You must also know God. Listen, people don't understand this. You must get a yearly revelation from now onwards. There is weekly, daily revelations, weekly revelations, monthly revelations, and the yearly revelation, and future revelation. Elijah said, do God do something without informing me? Why? Because Elijah is aware of every day, every week, every month, every year. But many Christians don't look at their revelation. It's your daily book that you need to take it. You need to take the daily book aside and daily your prophet daily aside and your revelation daily aside. Then you compare them. That make you see very far. But many Christians don't care for their dream. They don't care for their trance. They don't care for their revelation. They don't care for their prophecy. All what they do is, we go to church, we are Christian, you pray, and it's lack of knowledge. We need to understand this kind of thing. This is not your fault, because these things are not being taught Christians to know. We have been taught of giving only. And things is always repeating. Problems is repeating because we don't know how to walk with the Holy Spirit. First, do you know Holy Spirit? Do you have encounter with the Holy Spirit? How do you walk with the Holy Spirit? Do you know the voice of the Holy Spirit? Do you know the signal of the Holy Spirit? We don't know all these things. All what we do is, we are just Christian. We are wasting prayer. We are wasting the energy of prayer. You must understand daily vision, daily revelations. You must know monthly revelations, and you must know yearly revelation and future revelations. You must know them. That is why when they born Jesus, Bible said Herod came up, and then he called the Pharisees and this and this, and then they come on, send the book, let me know what are the revelations, what are the time that we are. Many Christians don't know the time. And you go to the book of Ecclesiastes, that there is time for everything, but we don't respect that time. I pray that before end of this month, you go on your knees and you begin to keep the revelation you have got. You begin to record the different kind of prophecy that have come upon your life, and you compare them to know at the moment that you are. We need to ask God to open our spiritual eyes. To open the Paul said, I pray that may the Lord open the eyes of your heart to enlighten the eyes of your heart. We are walking blindly in the Lord, or we are walking blindly with God. Every Christian, if you are a true believer, if you are really a servant of God, if you are really a daughter of God, if you are really a child of God, if you are really a born again Christian, you must respect this to guide your lifestyle. You must get it. You must know them. Bible says, and he has given us all spiritual blessings from above. You are entitled to have them. You are entitled to have your telephone to receive and to call. But if your telephone is only received, how do you make a call or make a contact when you needed to inform? Or if your telephone is only for call, you cannot receive. What are you doing? We know how to pray. We know how to talk to God. We know how to fast. But we don't know how to listen to God, how to see from God, how to understand from God. I'm encouraging brethren that we don't have to be ignorant Christians, totally blind Christians. No, please, I'm not insulting, but I'm telling you the writing, or else you blame the pastor, you blame the apostle, you blame the prophet, you believe people, and they will deceive you every day. And you'll be deceived every day. Because Bible says, lack of knowledge, my people perish, because you lack of divine or spiritual knowledge. You need to ask God to strengthen you and to help your spiritual personality to be uplifted. And so when you went to the mountain, something, a display begins from there. And so I repeat from verse 11. And he said, go forth and stand upon the mountain before the Lord. And behold, the Lord passed by, and a great and strong wind ran the mountains and break in pieces the rocks before the Lord. But the Lord was not in the wind. And after the wind, an earthquake. But the Lord was not in the earthquake. You must know the actual message that belongs to you. There are some people, when they go to church and maybe man of God is ministering, and the hand of God becomes so great, instead of closing their eyes, expecting God to touch them, they begin to open their mouth, their eyes, watching people. Abi, are you rich? What question in name a young microphone center and you be at any no the microphone what you have here one. And again, you have been and hop high. Now we have the who be a woman of one who happen. Dear Juman, dear Junan, and now the general. One for train, I mean, you say Radic Cassam, and we're ready and one century, and Rabbit Siberia Mansono. You be John Walker and perform for Pepper, or you are the other traffic is with Gatica. You be such a telephone. At the time, Name Abasa dead, and you pay when you mean watch your telephone. At the time that God is touching people's life, Holy Spirit inviting, visiting people, at the time, at the presence of God, in time of divine, encounter with God, you take your telephone, beginning to record the people there. What are you doing there? Are you a generous there? If the church have taken you a responsibility for that, it's your job. But if you have gone to prayer camp to pray, instead of you expecting God visitation to your life, you forget why you go to church and beginning to view people on their camera. People are beginning to watch people. What are they doing? What is happening? And you begin to give false news. You begin, hey, that church I go, that lady, the way you go, she have to dress well. What's wrong with you? Did you go to church to look after dressing? To mind our business when we are praying before God. Elijah go to God with an responsibility. He go to God with an agenda. He go to God with something important. And Bible says, God appeared to him and said, go and stand on the mountain, and I'm coming there. And Bible said, when God was coming, there is a display there. And so when you go to where divine of God or the manifestation of the Holy Spirit is taking place, you expect God to touch you. There are some people, when men of God call them to touch them, they begin to freeze themselves so that they will not fall. Are you going to fight? Are you going to fight so that the man of God will not push you down? Sit down. Don't go there. I believe you understand me. You must take an agenda before you go to church. Every Sunday, you must have an agenda to church. You must have an agenda of prayer every week, every month, every year, every season. Because you don't see, you don't hear, and you don't know. You are just a Christian. Just a Christian. You are just a Christian, and you always fall in victim. Blessed are those who overcome temptation, and they shall receive
the crown of glory. How can you overcome the temptation? Bible says, pray that you fall not into temptation. Did not say temptation will not come. Pray that you will not fall in. Therefore, you have an information to escape it. He did not say pray that, pray so that temptation will not come. He said pray so that you will not fall into temptation. Read the sentence well in your language. Stop that English. After all, you are not English born somebody. Take your local language, read it to understand it. It's not your fault. Even you don't know how to read your local language. Even your local language, you forget, you don't speak it. And that is one of the problems we have on our Christian ground. Take your local language or compare the different versions, read them and understand what Bible is saying there. He did not say pray that temptation will not come. He said pray that you will not fall into temptation. Pray ye that ye may not fall into temptation. Therefore, there will be an temptation, but you will not fall in. There will be an trap, but you will escape it. Bible says, when the enemy plot to assassinate the king of Israel, Elisha was given an accurate information to the king. And so they were wondering how it happens till the time that they found out there is a prophet in Israel which was given an accurate information, because the king always make selection. He tried all his best to make few selections that he trusts, but yet his trust was not working, because our God is omniscient God. He's omnipresent God. He's omnipotent God. He knows the the cue in your heart, in the vacuum of your heart, in the vacuum of your brain. He knows the decision, the direction, what you thought in your bed. Come on, my brother. We have to do something. We have been deceived as Christians. We have been deceiving ourselves for many times, for many years. I pray that you understand the word of God. I pray that you are awake in the spirit. I pray that you walk in the spirit. I pray that man, you know yourself in the spirit. For Bible said the spirit in us testifies that we are the child of God. Are you child of God? You need to stand on the mountain. You need to maintain yourself at the right place with God. And even a hand, a dancing, you wake up and dance this one in time of looking for God by visitation. Look, I can be anywhere, but I make sure I will not lose my concentration. I make sure I always expecting God sign, God singing, the voice of God. God can speak to you anywhere, but you must understand yourself that. Whom are you and where are you now? Why can't I? You were doing me, why can't I in the church? What's wrong with you? Huh? Is that the way you have to be? Go and do why can't I in the church? We must know what you are doing. Christian, I'm advising brethren and sisters, we don't have to involve ourselves with unnecessary argument. If you are preaching the word of God, maybe you will finish 25 people. They have let me go and sit up somewhere, beginning to argue about unnecessary matter. You see how many thousands of people that want to hear that argue. How can somebody go and listen to somebody who is insulting God? Don't you know you are defiling your spiritual being, your spiritual nature? There are some words you don't need to hear from your ear. When you hear somebody speaking an evil word, an insulting word against the Most High God, you must hate that word and you must hate that position. You don't need to go there. If somebody insulting your father, if somebody insulting your mother, which you don't can't do anything, will you be listening there? You'll be going there to listen. You will keep your way from there. Assuming your mother have been put in naked, showing on the CNN, showing the Facebook, will you every day go and listen to it? Position yourself at the right place. Expect to hear the voice of God. Forget about an ignorant and wicked people. Forget about the agencies. You have to know the agent of demons. They are not antichrist. There are also another agent. Let's tap the category of agencies. We must know them and keep ourselves away from them and position ourselves. And so Bible says, when you go, so many things happen. And after the earthquake, fire. But the Lord was not in the fire. And after the fire, still small voice. Still small voice came out.
And all the demonstrations. When you go to church as a man of God, lift your hands and let the Lord touch you. Open your heart looking for people. A man of God say, come, let me pray for you. You go and stand strong so that he's not going to fight with you. God will never touch you. You will just go in vain. Sometimes God touch people angrily. Holy Spirit touch people angrily. He will just touch you to rule, rule, rule. You get nothing. But some people immediately they touch ground. They begin to hear a sound. Some people immediately, man of God, touch them. They begin to hear a sound. Some people immediately, because you must go to church with focus. With focus. We must pray with focus. We must appear before man of God with focus. I pray that God give you wisdom in a divine encounter. Because many people encounter with God, but yet they don't have any knowledge of it. God speaks to so many people, yet they don't have idea. How did Hannah get to know God is speaking to him? Meanwhile, man of God there was ignorant to the voice of God. When he hear a man of God saying something, he pay attention to that and answer him as speaking with God. Because Hannah got to know is the voice of God. But the man of God was misinterpreting, was mismanaging the voice of God. And says, sir, please, 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 I beg, don't misinterpret my thought. I'm a servant of the Lord. I cry unto the God. I came and pour my heart before God. Please answer me well. And he said, go, may the Lord grant you a favor. And may the Lord do your heart desire. And he took that word as a word of God. And it was established. And it was established. But the man of God was ignorant to what he was talking about. If man of God did not pay attention to the voice of God, you can pay attention to the voice of God and take the word and you'll be granted in it. When we go to church, if man of God talk 500 good words and speak or circle of mouth of true words, you keep that word in your gumption. Always remember that, hey, last time he said this, I wonder why he was able to say that. But the prophecy that belongs to you, you never even pay attention to hear of it. A prophecy belongs to you, but you always give bad thought to it. That why every day did he that sister prophesied? Every day he say one thing, it is because God wants to tell you something you don't understand it. So God will repeat that prophecy to the day you understand that, oh sure, God is speaking to me. When you go to church, you examine, you have only bad thought into it. Stand on the rock, hard yourself. You must understand the voice of God. A prophecy has been coming, repeating good 7 times, and it's for you. You don't know because you are angry with that sister that every day he prophesies and says this. Every day one thing that he has been prophesying. It is because you don't hear, you don't understand. God wants you to hear and understand what he's talking about. And the day you understand it as God is speaking to you, that prophecy will not come anymore. Don't you know you are the one that warned that prophet? God bless all those who are on the board. Please help me to share this program, invite the people, because this is a divine encounter education. You must learn this, you must understand this, so that you'll be able to please God. Sister Agatha, God bless you, and Naomi, God bless all of you. You are all welcome. Help me to share the program and invite the people also to get into the program. And after we are preaching in the First Kings chapter 19 from 8 to downward, we'll close from here to another place. I'm reading verse 12. And after the earthquake fire, but the Lord was not in the fire, after the fire, still small voice. How many people have heard the voice of God? How many people have heard the voice of the Holy Spirit? How many Christians know Holy Spirit? And how many Christians know the encounter or a moment encounter with the Holy Spirit?
I think they are coming.
Okay, but there are people on the ground. Amen. I believe that somebody, I'm speaking to somebody. Please, if the sound is not okay, you might also give me information. You might also give me information. Mostly I'm working with double line here movement, so sometimes I'm not getting chance as you are getting it then. May God bless you wherever you are. Now, and the Bible says, and the still small voice, I pray that before end of this year, you must get encounter with God. You must hear the voice of God in your ear. I pray that may God open your spiritual ear to hear the voice of God. I pray that may God open your spiritual eyes, the eyes of your heart, so that you may see Holy Spirit. Then you might walk with the Holy Spirit. God, Bible says, pray that you not fall into temptation. But we pray that we will not encounter with temptation. That is mystic. It's not the right channel. The right channel that pray that you will not fall into temptation. Therefore, even though the temptation will come, but you will know how to escape. Bible said the Lord know how to save his people in time of trouble. But if the trouble is coming and you are unaware and you are ignorant to God's protection, you will still fall in it and still cry. No parent will allow a child to fall in victim of an incident or to fall in victim or to fall in my hole. You try all your best to handle the child, either to beat the child or kill the child off if it is so critical. So sometimes there are some things God is kicking you out of that place because you're already in it. We need to maintain ourselves. And Bible said there was fire. And when I read from verse 13 there, then we go to another place. And it was so when Elijah hear it that he wrapped his face in his mantle. Come on. He wrapped his face with his mantle. Why? No one will see God and live. Why? If you can look at everything on earth here, you cannot see God. Sometimes you need to wrap your face. What do face wrapping face mean? When you wrap your face, your eyes will close and your ear also will burn and your mouth will also what? Limit because of your nose. Close your eyes from beautiful ladies that is crossing at the street. Close your eyes from unnecessary issues. Bible says, feed not yourself when wicked are prospering. Close your eyes from a certain business that people are making it easy. You don't know their end. Close your eyes from where you don't belong to. How people are making chances, people are making it. You don't know the secret behind. Close your eyes that you might not fall in victim of up. Close your ear from what you are hearing that doesn't support your spiritual goals. But we open our eyes, watching everything, looking all privilege. There are some privilege you don't belong to them because you are not part of them. But we want to take the food of the satanic food and enjoy it while the Satan is given to their own children. There are some kind of position unless you sell your soul to the demons before you get it. And what lie do you belong to? When you talk of gain, people are talking, I'm worried. I'll have to one time come out with sexual ignorance. This have making me to know Ghanaians are totally almost are sexual ignorant. Let me tell you a secret and a mystery to understand this. Gay is not about sex. Gay is about spiritual act. There are slavery gay sex. They are under slavery. They are under attack. They don't have any option when they involve themselves. But it's an occult society. I repeat, there are many people that just come out with Facebook, say whatever they want to say.
do WhatsApp and say whatever you don't, you just say it. I've been traveled from my childhood. I have been with so many different nationals and so many different countries. And I understand so many kind of occult organizations. It's not about sex. When you talk of gay, you talk of gays, men, women, what is lesbianity? You talk of bestiality, and you talk of other different defilation that you might not even know. You know people have affair with tree, with wood, with the sun. It's an organization. So people just ignorant themselves and die in it. You think it's just something that people are just doing it? No. We are ignorant to that. If you don't know, you don't have idea about it, keep yourself mouth. Somebody say, if the government will sign it and then he helped the country. Nobody's above the law. If a state sign a law, sign an agreement, it bound to everybody. You might not do it, but your children are going to suffer for it. I'm not speaking, I'm not after your ignorant political attitude that you are doing in Ghana as Ghanaians. We are totally also ignorant in politics. We're just speaking it in anyhow. We don't know political and economical engineering assistance or aid or system. We just join party. How many Ghanaians are in Europe and they are an effective members of the party? We just talk anything at all. You are washing toilet in Europe with your certificate and you go to Ghana and say things that you don't know. Don't say what you don't know, please. We will confuse our economical agendas if we focus on unnecessary things. If you are a Christian, be on your line. Pray to God to enlighten you, to help you to be at the right position. I don't want to compromise on that issue, but I'm just giving you an idea that is a spiritual organization. There are people that gays that have sex with men, and Bible said we should kill them because of a reason. Women, Bible said we should kill them because of a reason. Bestiality, Bible said we should kill them a reason. All this kind of things that I'm mentioning about is an act of organizations. When you talk of idol worship, how many have you seen an idol in Africa without Paul Abation? We do Paul Abation, right? We share blood of animals, right? Some share blood of human being, right? They are also the same thing. So don't say what you don't know. Many people are ignorant. They have their shrines. They have their leaders. They are an occult. People are ignorant to that. And many that involve themselves, they die prematurely because they don't know they are selling themselves. Bible said, when you have affair with a prostitute, you have become one body with that. We have to be very careful to talk of what we don't know. And many of them are also trying to frustrate their information. That is why they come out with any information at all, things that people will not look at it. We are not all Ghanaians are ignorant to spiritual matters. So please, if you are given option about gay, please don't pretend and give false news of it. It is a spiritual organization. It is an occult organization. It involves spiritual, sexual offering. Let me say offering of a ritual act. We have to be very, very careful. They are not common humans. Imagine somebody will sleep with animal, will sleep with dog for 1 year before he found a human being to sleep with, and immediately you find that person, the person is going to die within some 40 days. And again, even the gang is nothing. We are practicing in Ghana. Search them out. Bible says we should keep these people out of human souls. Search them out. The time will come. We lose shoes. You might not understand it. Your daughter may just go out and come and die, just like that. Your son may go out and come and die, just like that. Do you think they are free in Europe? Do you think
let somebody die by their act system and see how they handle the issue.
Now, let me continue with this. And so Bible said, when he rubbed his face, I repeat verse 13, please. I just enlighten you on issues. We are in the darkened age of this life. Now, verse 13 says, and it was so when Elijah heard it, that he wrapped his face in his mantle and went out and stood in the entrance in of the cave. And behold, there came a voice unto him and said, what do thou hear, Elijah? Let me end up here. I'm encouraging you, my brother, my sister. You don't need prayer. Today, you don't need prayer. At this moment, you don't need prayer. You need to go into your inner door. You need to keep yourself on the mountain. You need to climb the mountain. You need to go in the cave. You need to cover your face. There are some women that are deceiving or will be deceived by gifts. Many women are expecting guys to give them gifts. Go away from that. You need a husband, not a gifted and intrusive guys. Many men are in expectation of those girls that give them. My brother, you need a true partner. Not every gift even should meet you at your home. There are some gifts they don't have to meet you at your home. You need to run away from gifts. You need to run away from evil visitations. You need to run away from a certain movement in your life. We don't have to be a ceremonial Christian. Bible says it's time to worship the Lord in spirit and in truth. And those who do so, such are the Lord sick. Such are the Lord sick. That those who worship him in spirit and in truth. The Lord is searching for those who will not be ignorant, but who will be wise-acted Christians to reveal himself, to walk with them. We don't have to expect anyhow people to meet us. We need to acknowledge an evil relationship of people and keep our way, our life from them. This is the time you are mature. This is the time that you need to obtain degrees. Caleb said, I was 50 years. I was 40 years. At that age that you bless me, I'm still at the same thing, at the same strength, stronger. This is the time for my portion. You need to claim your portion of sources, portion of your anointing, portion of your grace. But you must acknowledge yourself, whom you are. Present your, claim your right as a child of God. Please, this is the time that we need to acknowledge ourselves as a true servant of God. You need to be born again, child of God. From now onwards, if you know that you depend on the strength of God, we are in the darkened age of the world. Many people have involved themselves with an societies, with an organization, with an a movement that they don't know the secret behind them. This is the time that you need to prove yourself as an immature child of God to obtain the grace of God upon your life. You need to make a positive confession by believing yourself. This is the time that you need to rededicate your life to Jesus Christ. This is the time that you need to rebuild the bridge of salvation. And there you see the grace of God. Let's quickly look at the book of Matthew chapter, 7, verse 24. Quickly turn me to there. The book of Matthew chapter 7, verse 24. And let's look at something over there. 24-27, let me read quickly. Therefore, whosoever hear of this saying of mine and do them, I will like him unto a wise man who built his house upon a rock, and the rain descended, and the flood came, and the wind blew and beat upon the house, and it fell not, for it was founded upon a rock. Hi, I want you to build your rock on the mountains. This is the time that you need to know where you are building your destiny, where you are building your children, where you are building your marriage. You must find a place to put your foundation. We build our marriage foundation on the wrong place, which we don't know whom we are going to marry, where we belong to. We accept people options in our destiny, which we don't have right foundation at the right place. Bible says it, he will count the person like a person who built his house on top of the rock. And when the natural sources, when the rain, when the wind blows, oh, Bible said because the house was on top of the rock, so he was able to maintain the rock, sustain him, and he kept till the end of the trouble, and so he found in the right place. And so, my brother, I want to tell you that you need to build yourself at 2018. If you maintain yourself at the natural source, the earth is going to shock, the whole world is going to shake. I'm giving you information in advance because you might not be able to achieve your goal because of what I'm telling you right now. You need to build yourself on Christ at this 2018. There are going to be an financial our economic improvement in every part of the world, but many people are going to fall in victim of trouble and problem and tears and cry. But I want to tell you that if you build yourself on the rock, that is Jesus Christ. If you build yourself on the rock, there is an exorcist in the rock. Remember that when there was nothing to eat, when there was nothing to survive, God said, go and speak to the rock, and the rock will give you food. And so Bible said, go and speak to the rock, and the rock will give you water. And so Bible said, go and speak to the rock, and the rock will give you an energy. And so water gush out this year that you are going to an end. You need to build yourself on the rock. And so before 2018, you must understand yourself. You are true dedicated Christian. You must understand yourself that you are true born again Christian. You are not a deceiving Christian. You are not betraying Christian, and you are not backsliding Christian. This is the time that we need to rededicate ourselves. This is the time that our spirit in us must testify that we are true born again. Go away from that man. If the man don't want to marry you, maintain your position for God to bring your right partner. How do you deceive yourself that the man must know how I am? The man said, we are deceiving. Christianity is deceiving by our same minister who called themselves man of God. Anybody that encourage you to have sexual to contaminate yourself with a man or a woman before you marry is a false man of God. You need to keep yourself holy. Your relationship don't need 4, 5, 10 years. When you find someone, pray to God. If it is yes, God will say yes, and you go on. Please, don't be offended. I'm telling you the truth. Don't be offended. I'm telling you the truth. We need to know the truth, and the truth shall, set us free. This is the time that me and you, this is the time that all of us need to know the truth, walk according to the gospel, walk according to the true word of God. We need to be at the right position, and we need to do the right thing. And I know God is going to do something. 2018, everyone must be on top of his or her own rock, at the right rock. If you be in the on the ground or common ground, if you be at where people are dancing, that is not their home. Here is where many Christians are fools, because I'm sorry to say fools, it is because we follow people to do what people are doing, which we don't know where they hide themselves, where they are, where they put themselves. People come to public and dance and disgrace there, and they go to their secret place and sleep. But Christians still maintain themselves there. Bible said, and the wise virgin fools also follow them. When the wise went, they prepared themselves for an extra. But when fools was going, they prepared themselves and enjoy it. Let me tell you that you don't need to enjoy Christmas just because of unnecessary gift that somebody is going to betray you on it. You need to present yourself. You need to bring your agenda out. You need to make an agenda to God and say, God, here I am. Bible said, ask your heart desire. The Lord will provide it. When? God will give it. When are you going to ask your heart desire? What do you want to do for 2018 that should be a blessing to your soul? Are you secure for that 2018 that you are going? Satan also have prepared their agenda. And so Bible said, when King Herod called the guys and said, look, Go and find the guy, and when you find him, give me a message. I also will go and bow up to that guy, because it is written and it's very, very important to me. But he was having an evil agenda. He was having an evil agenda. There is an evil agenda on you on 2018. But when you make a righteous agenda with Jesus Christ, you escape. Bible said, pray that you not fall into temptation. It did not say pray that temptation will not come. I want you to understand the scripture and put it at the right place. And so what I want you to understand is, you need to pray that you get the divine revelation. And so Bible said, an angel of God appeared to Joseph in the revelation and said, take away from this place. Go and hide that child from so and so please, so that at the right time you bring the, can't God take him and hide? Can't God freeze the asset of the king? But God permit the king to perform rightly, correctly, so that none of the body guys will fall the victim of the king's wrath. So he took the child away. When they didn't find it, the child, the king walked in vain. Sometimes you need to know the right agenda of God, so that you escape the plot and the plans of the enemy. Somebody have done all his best, have suffered in cold in this Europe here for many years. At the time that he obtained passport, he go and take cocaine and die in it. Look at how many years before you can get paper, how many years before you can obtain passport, then that you can make a movement agenda that you want to make, and immediately he get a passport, he just go and take okay and die, which have suffered for many years to work. He did not benefit anything from his social security. It is because the evil agenda track him down. He's supposed to ask God, what am I doing with the passport? Where am I going to hide myself? What should I do? He just submit passport, and he suffered for many years, giving to lawyers. Lawyers spend money with him. And then after he got everything, he involved himself with an unnecessary issue. Somebody immediately, he get his papers, I'm going home to rejoice. He go on with somebody's wife, and they kill him as an armed robber. Not that he's armed robber. He wasn't armed robber, because he was act in the acts of an sexual immoral. And then they say, what do we do? Let's call him a real. Let's call him criminal. And people just begin to beat the person and kill him. He had just come from abroad. He found a fine lady, beautiful lady. Somebody might warn him that he have a husband, but he thought he's driving his car. He thought he's come from abroad. He thought he can do whatever he do and go home. Because some friends came home and do that and come and report that, wow, when I go, I rejoice. And he drag that lady. Hey, immediately they found that you come from abroad. Wow, they don't care for whatever even you give to them. They need you, my brother. So you need to ban your head from evil voices and close your eyes from evil inventions. Not everything that your eyes must see, and not everything that you must hear in your ear, that should be enter or will not enter into. We need to renew our focus. We need to set a new focus tonight. If you can set a new focus, and then you set for a rock, which is Jesus Christ, and how will I build? Then you need to plan, that you need to make a new plan of your house, that I'm going to build set up of house on this rock, that I can maintain myself. When the storm comes, I'll be able to maneuver in it. When the storm blew, I'll be able to hide myself. If you are dependent on the rock, when the storm coming from east, you go and hide yourself in the west. When coming from the north, you go to the south. So you'll be able to know the direction of the storm, and then you know how to keep yourself, so that you'll be free up. So you'll be free storm Christian. I pray that God give you such a wisdom and knowledge to understand this. For 2018, you will flourish. Bible said, you shall be like trees standing at the riverside, and you bear fruit at the season. But don't think riverside is easier. At the riverside, sometimes the river overflow. And when river overflow, sometimes it shifts. The sand there, most of the trees that are standing riverside sometimes fall prematurely because they are not at the right position. You might be at the riverside, but not on the rock. You may fall when the sun, or when the sea, or when the river overflow with high storm, with hard storm. At the riverside, there is a strong storm at the riverside. And so if you want to be at the riverside as God is speaking, must be at the right position. If you be at the riverside on top of common storm, when the rain fall, and the banks of the river overflow and the wind blow, you surely go down. Not every tree that can maintain themselves at the riverside. But if you wish to be at the riverside, prepare yourself, maintain yourself on the rock that is at the riverside. I repeat again, not every tree can survive at the riverside. Bible says you will be like a tree standing at the riverside, and you will not mind when the heat comes because of the sources that you have. But not every tree succeed at the riverside. If you did not be at the right position, the rain will fall and the banks of the river will overflow and the storm will blow. If you are not true Christian, you fall in victim. I want you to be born again Christian. Maintain yourself on the rock, standing on the rock with a good agenda, with a good motive, with a strong determination, with a new focus as born again. You must be focused to be born again. Bible says, seek ye the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all will be added unto thee. If you get new focus, preparing your mind means getting a new focus, making a new agenda and focus on it, that at this 2018, I'm going to be an a true usher. I'm going to be an intercessor, intercede on the people, on behalf of the church, of the people, of the pastor. I'm going to be an evangelist, to evangelize on behalf of the ministry. I'm going to do this. I'm going to do that. You must have agenda in the gospel that will guide your feet to be. Bible said, and you, thou have made my feet as an hen standing on the rock. That will give you an a strong feet in the church. Let ignorant support of mouth in the church. Let ignorant the weaknesses, pastors and prophets and ministers. They are all human beings like you. God will make you greater as you see them, even than them. Bible says your beginning is small, your end shall be great. So if you begin to focus on the mistake of great man, you can never be a great man. But who focus at the good side of great man always get their point and become greater than them, because you have your own power, your own gift, your own talent, adding into a stature make you greater. And that is why Bible said you are beginning small, because you must see great things before you can do great things. So Bible said, and the foolish man also build in the sun and fall down. Please go away from a foolish man. Who is a foolish man? A dream killer, a people that don't support good idea, a people that don't respect people's dream and visions, people that don't respect people's options, people that always looking their better best, and that is all. People that always soak from you, people that always try to gain from you, people that don't just betray you anyhow. They can go with you in a movement that will benefit from them, but when they find out that you are going to benefit, they will find means to squeeze their face. Frown their face on you and go away, shift from you quickly, and you disappointed. Go away from treason friends, treason wife, treason girlfriends, treason boyfriends, treason family members. Maintain yourself with God and expect God. Bible said, and Jacob worked with God alone, and he succeeded. If you build your rock, stand alone with God. Determine your Christianity alone. If you determine your Christianity with friends, you will always fail, because there are some people that have different agenda in their Christian ground. At the church there are people that are doing their different business there. There are people that enjoying different kind of evil filtering. Bible said, and the sons of Eliah was even having affair with the girls, with the ladies in the house of God. Why? Samuel maintained himself at the right position with God. You need to stand on the rock alone. You must concentrate. If you know why? If you're standing at high place with somebody, you cannot focus on something that is so far. But if you are standing alone, you'll be able to concentrate and focus on the far thing, so that you will know what is ahead, what is coming, what to do
Welcome, Ajaya. Welcome, Richard. Adjai, man of God. God bless you, my brother. Friend Pond, Techi. God bless you, Mr. McMahon. Osei, Kwaju. Oh, God bless you, my brother. Man of God. Another combat. Ghana community chairman in Spain, Barcelona, Catalonia. Nana Kwaku. And God bless you, wherever you are. Also, Elizabeth Nyako. God bless all of you. Esten Marco. God bless you, all of you. God bless you for your good work and your effort to reach today. Please help me to send this message to help our Christian brethren. Help me to preach this message. Means help me to invest in this program. By investing on this program means inviting people to it. Send it to people. People need to get such an idea, because in the church, we are not saying the truth. We are not saying the truth. We are just telling people giving. We are telling people about this and that and that and that. And people are not growing in knowledge. And if we grow in the knowledge, we will prosper. We will achieve our goal. We will see our dreams. I mean, we will be able to please God when we fall in victim of temptation, hardly to survive. Let me quickly turn to the book of Mark 4, verse 4. The book of Mark, verse 4, 418. I'm getting to an end, but I just want to chip on in some things that is very, very important, so that we'll be able, I believe that 2018, somebody, 2018, you are going to flourish. Call me and encourage me that, man of God, it has happened and God have done it. I'm telling you, you are going to conceive and give birth to a very nice child. Call me and say, man of God, you have prophesied and it has come to pass. I mean, you call me for something. I know God is going to do something. And before end of this year, hey, somebody, I can see your star shining. And every veil that enemy has put on you is already taken away. The glory of God is shining on somebody. Just see it mean unto your soul. That is the book of Mark chapter 4, verse 18. And the Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he hath anointed me to preach the gospel. Sorry. Okay, let me end there. Anointed me, that is, sorry, go to the mic, the book of Luke, chapter 4, verse 18. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he have anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He sent me to heal the broken heart, to preach deliverance to the captive, and to recover of sight of the blind, to set the liberty them that are bruised, to preach the acceptable year of the Lord. Somebody, take a prophecy on this. Write the book of Luke, chapter 4, verse 18 and 19. Sign, underline your agenda in it. The Lord Almighty have called me to preach an acceptable year of the Lord, to set you at liberty. But you need to underline something, that God, here is my case and need you to intervene. He said, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. He anointed me. The anointing upon me is to minister unto you that are poor. I mean, to be rich. The next year, you are going to be a seed above your imagination, to send me to heal. And every sickness that's upon you, I declare healing upon you. And every broken heart that consider I've shattered of dream, whomsoever your dream have been shattered, whomsoever someone have deceiving you, God is going to give you an multiplication system of blessing of sources into your life, that your life are not going to be the same. Those who love best, you are going to love best, to preach deliverance unto the captive, whomsoever that is suffering from any kind, from any kind of spiritual oppression, whomsoever some suffering from any kind of addiction, whomsoever that is suffering from any spiritual attack, spiritual marriage, spiritual distraction, rakataburu shanduriyama, I cover you with the fire of the Holy Ghost. I set a fire war to deliver you from whatsoever enemy have determined on you. I set you at liberty to deliver to them that are captive. I set you from every captivity system and every captivity organization and every captivity
root or system or tap are set to at liberty to preach demons unto them that are captive, to recover the sight of the blind. You will see this year. If you are a true Christian, if you agree and open your mind and focus on your Christian ground, focus on Jesus, determine with the holiness and agree with the Holy Spirit, this year you must have a foresight. Your sight must open. You must see the visions. You must see the trance. You must see the revelations and understanding. The eyes of your heart must open in the name of Jesus. I decree it and take it as your portion, because you needed it to set the liberty upon them that are bruised. I don't know how much enemy have been maltreating you. I don't know how long you have gone through maltreating in your life. You have been maltreated in your life. You have been mismanaged in your life. I don't know how much you have been deceiving. I don't know how, what kind of treason people that have been frustrated in your life. Help get your liberty. Rakaburu Shekabia Sanduriyama, to preach the acceptable year of the Lord. The Lord have accepted your option, have accepted your prayer, have accepted your supplication. Give your life as a holy sacrifice, living holy sacrifice, acceptable unto the Lord. All your sins have been pardoned. Bible said this is the reason of your worship. You need to, give your life to Jesus Christ now. And God is going to do something great, something supernatural above your imagination. You are going to see the great manifestation of God, the great manifestation of God in your life. Celebration is not going to cease in your house this year. This year you are going to celebrate what you have been crying for, what you have been expecting for, what you have been expecting for years, what you have been crying for years. Bible says something hard for the Lord. By this time, before I come, you will have your son, you will have your breakthrough, you have got your breakthrough. I decree it upon your soul, I decree it upon your life. But by this time, you have a testimony, a notable testimony upon your life. Mashakaburu Sanduriyama. Thank you, Lord Jesus. We give you glory, Lord. We magnify your glorious name. You are the Alpha and Omega. We worship you, adore. You are worthy to be praised. You are the Alpha and Omega. We worship you, adore. You are worthy to be praised. We give you honor and glory. We worship you, adore. You are worthy to be. Mashababa ya kaburu shediriyama, ramaya sakaburu shakatabi ya sandriyama, desha baba ya kabama mama, say you are the Alpha and Omega. We worship you, adore. You are worthy to be. We give you honor and glory. Oh, we worship you, adore. You are worthy to be praised. We give you worship you, adore. You are worthy to be praised. Thank you, Holy Spirit. I can feel the presence of God so great at where you are. There is an especial unction on you. There is an especial presence of God. There is a rain on you. There is a rain on you. Receive touch right now, wherever you are. Lift your hands
Receive it now. Say, touch my life. Touch my life. Touch my life. Have your way, oh God. Have your way upon my life. Do as you want. Let your will be done. Let your will be done. Let your will be done. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Let your will be done. Amen. Now, finally, let's go to the book of 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 13, going down. 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 13, going down. That is the final quotation I'm giving. And take this. He said, wherefore, gather up the loins of your mind, be sober, and hope to the end for the grace that is to be brought unto you at the revelation of Jesus Christ. Guard your mind. Guard your mind. Guard your loins of your mind. Be sober and hope to the end of coming of Jesus Christ. Means focus your mind. Get a revelation of Christ. Be born again means focus on Christ. Get a focus on Christ. Get a determination of Christ. Get a vision of Christ. Determine on your focus in Christ. For the revelation that is coming. For the grace that is coming upon your life. As obedient child, not as fashion yourself according to the former lust of your ignorance. No one is perfect, but this is the time to determine to be perfect. Determine to be perfect means determine to be mature. Focus on the maturity in Christ. Focus on maturity in Christ. Determine to be an mature Christian, and God will mature you. Determine to walk according to the grace of God, and depending on the grace of God, and the grace will feed you, and the grace will protect you, and the grace will provide you, and the grace will increase you, and they lift you. This is the moment of encounter with God. You need to determine to make your mind to focus on Christ. You don't need to fashion yourself according to the former things, according to the former functions. You don't need to fashion yourself according to the way people are doing, for you don't know them in the spirit. You just see them physically, but you must agree yourself and get proof, improve yourself. The spirit in you must witness what is in you. You can't know somebody. You can't know your father, your mother, your wife, your sister, your friend. After all, listen. Esau's mother that called Jacob and said, your father is going to bless your brother. Come and let me help you. If not, your brother will take blessing. And he snatched the blessing from the hand of Esau and give to Jacob. You can't trust everybody. If you love your husband or your wife or your son, your daughter, your mother, your friend. This is the time to focus on Christ. You can trust only in Jesus Christ. You must trust yourself that you have really dedicated your life to God. Give your life to Jesus Christ. Forget about everything. And you will see the divine multiplication of blessings upon your life. So that God wants to bless you alone. Sometimes God wants to bless you. He wants you to get true evidence of his blessing without hand of man. But you are learning, you are lying on somebody. You are relying on somebody's sources. You are relying on somebody's help. You are relying on somebody's confidence. But God wants you to get a confidence and proof to yourself that you are mature. You say, focus on Christ. But I read 14 going down. As obedient child, not fashion yourself according to the former lust in your ignorance, but as he which had called you is holy, so be ye holy in all manner of your conversation, because it is written, be ye holy, for I am holy. Without holiness, no one will see God. Someone said, well, I can't live without smoking. You can see God. I can't live without drinking. You can't see God. I can't live without having an affair with man. You can't see God. I can't live with an affair with woman. You can't see God. I can't live without doing that business. You can't see God. I can't anything that your life, your thought tell you that you can't stop. That thought is leading you. You can't see God if this thought continue in your life. I want to encourage you that go away from such kind of function that is not of God. And from now onwards, I tell you by the word of God that you are going to exceed above your companion. You are going to exceed above your imagination. God Almighty have set a goal of promotion into your life, that you are going to rejoice on what you have been crying for years, what you have been expecting. This is the time to grab your revelation. This is the time to grab your prophecy, that you are going to, Bible says, your beginning is small, your end shall be great. You are going to be great if only you can dedicate your life to God, only if you can focus on the born again system, only if you can focus on salvation, only if you can focus on your calling and determine to walk according to the principle way of God. God is going to, usher you with the power of the Holy Spirit. God is going to, strengthen you. God is going to carry you upward. God is going to promote you. He's going to uplift you. He's going to transform the way of your life. You are going to see the supernatural manifestation of the Holy Spirit upon your life. And you will see the greatness of God in you, because your light will shine. And the brightness of God, the brightness of your soul, the brightness of your star is going to shine, and you are going to see the divine blessings of God. You are going to bless the name of the Lord. Your tears have come to an end. I want you to be beginning to smile with an expectation of focusing of your Christian life, and focus on your prayer, that God have answered your prayer, and you must receive it right now. Take it as you are expecting. Take it as you hope for, because my prayer does not depend on your hope. It doesn't depend on your faith. It depends on the anointing of God. May every yoke that is upon you be broken right now, and every chains and rod have been set against your soul, every ritual have been performed against your soul, I break it down in the name of Jesus. I set you at liberty. Get your healing from any kind of sicknesses. Where there is no hope, what you don't have hope for, what you don't even trust anymore, what you have lost hope, take your hope and the proof of God's existence in your life, that you are going to meet it. God is going to meet it for you. It's not by your strength, not by your power, but by the power of the Holy Spirit. Since the Lord, you are covered by the blood of Jesus. I set firewood around you, around your family. I set firewood at whatever you are. Any demon that will detain, any evil that will detain, any powers of darkness, even Marian powers, every idol, every witchcraft, every dragon, every demonic spirit that will detain, every agent being appointed over your soul that will fly or that will make any move closer to you, fire of the Holy Ghost will burn them off in the name of Jesus. I decree firewood around you. I decree the firewood, whosoever that is listening to my voice, that is going under the shadow of my voice, I decree firewood around you to protect you and guide you from every sources of destruction. Every journey that you are going to meet, whosoever that is hiding in your way, let the lion fall on them, let the fire fall on them. Whosoever that have set trap to push you in, let that person fall on that trap in the name of Jesus. Enemy will destroy. May the fire consume the enemy, whatever they are hiding themselves. Let them fall on their own trap. Let the angel chase them. May their way be darkened and stripped, and let them fall on their own destruction. Whosoever that is eating from the sources of your finances, let that person die prematurely in the name of Jesus. Whosoever that have set betting upon your life, I break every yoke in the name of Jesus. I break every yoke upon your life. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Lord Jesus. We are going to have another 7 days program. Prepare yourself to be part of it. And I know that at the right time, I don't want to give you a time that I might not be able. I'm waiting upon the Lord. Prepare yourself. From now onwards, we may also encounter another 7 days of breaking chains. May God bless you wherever you are. Please immediately after I finish, you can call me from now onwards at any time and I pray with you. Secondly, try to tag this or send it to whomsoever that will wish you better. Let that person get to this message. And I know that God is going to work in the life of that person. God bless you wherever you are. May the Spirit of the Lord set around you and protect you. May the angel of God keep standing beside you so that you see the divine manifestation of the Holy Spirit. I pray that may the Lord Almighty show himself strong upon your life and you are going to glorify the name of the Lord, because it is not by our strength, not by our power, but by the power of the Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. You are God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. You are eternal King of glory.